Welcome to the third episode of Butts and Stuff Podcast. As usual, I am ashlinski, and with me as always is Tyler, aka Toriadorian.
Yo.
I don't feel like screaming right now. I think my throat's hoarse.
We've had a long day.
So we'll start off with our usual butt of the week segment, which is a really strange thing to say, is a usual segment. But this week's butt of the week is gonna be Miss Scarlett Johansson. Get a little variety in there. Got some boy butts, and now we have a girl butt. Cause we all saw Civil War and Avengers and she in Iron Man 2?
She's in a lot.
I know she's in the second Iron Man, but those are the most that I know her butt from, the Marvel movies.
And she fits into leather nicely. I wish I fit into leather like that.
I want to know if that suit's made of like real leather or fake leather.
I don't know.
That's what I want to know.
Watch it not be leather at all.
Watch it be like something like, I don't even know. You know more costuming things than me. I'm sure you can figure it out.
I mean, you can make stuff look like leather that isn't leather.
Like pleather?
Shit. No, not pleather. Smartass.
Like faux leather?
This is not the podcast that we are speaking of this in.
This is a great start, as usual. We don't have like a solid plan. The plan that we kind of sort of were discussing before was like different shows we've watched and like.
When do we ever have a solid plan?
We don't. We just kind of go, let's maybe talk about this.
Maybe.
Let's maybe hope we stay on track and not deviate off it. But if we're going to talk about shows, can we start with not the one I was just watching, but we should start with Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Oh my god.
First off, because it's in our home state.
Yep.
I don't think they film it in Philadelphia. I'm not sure. I probably should look that up because I've been wanting to know for a while. When do they work in that show? It keeps me up at night sometimes. I'm just like, do they ever do their actual job at the bar?
Nope.
Because, you know, they've went and got, like, side jobs and when they worked at the mailroom in the Pepe Silvia episode. They're like, yeah, we had to get jobs to get health insurance. Like, dude, you guys could have just purchased some health insurance for the bar. That's a thing. I'm gonna look
now up. That would be way too easy.
It's so easy.
Oh my god. Freaking Mac was always my favorite character in Sunny. He's always my favorite.
I love how he just turned into the running gag. Like, he might be gay, he acts it, but it's just the running gag now.
He's something, alright.
I haven't watched. Like, I know the new season is airing right now, season 12.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. I feel like maybe at some point they should touch on this so it can come to light finally. But I don't think they ever will.
I don't think they will either, to be honest.
Oh, while I'm thinking about it and trying to Google it, fun fact, someone that I used to be friends with, one of their relatives was in, like, Jersey somewhere, and they saw them filming on the boardwalk. I don't know what they were filming, but
mm-hmm.
I remember that, because they were bragging, and I'm like, screw you.
It's only good when I have bragging rights.
Exactly. I don't think. Okay, I don't think they actually film in Philadelphia.
They probably film in, like, New York.
It looks like they do in, like, Atlanta and LA. But sometimes they actually film things in Philly. Literally the start of this article that I'm looking at says, you might assume that a show with Philadelphian title is in the title is filmed in the city of brotherly love, but in the case of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, you'd be wrong. It's mostly filmed in LA. Once or twice a season, though, they go to Philadelphia for a few days. Oh, that's cool. Man, I thought Patty's Pub was actually in Philly somewhere.
Nope.
Now my dream is crushed. I just want to go meet Charlie Day.
So no road trip when you come up.
God damn it. Although, like, I would not say no to Philly because, oh.
Right, there's much to do up there.
The Reading Terminal Market. Shout out to them. They're so good. Tyler.
Yes.
It's your turn. Take the show. Let's discuss it.
Oh, is it a show that we've both watched?
I mean, chances are I've either watched it or heard of it.
Okay. So, lately I've been obsessed. It's a little bad. With the series The Magicians.
I want to watch that.
Oh, it's so good. I love it. So.
Ooh, I swallowed wrong. I swallowed wrong and then I breathed wrong. So it was a great combination. I was under the impression it was about magicians.
Well, obviously, yes.
But then I saw the promos for season 2 and I'm like, wait, what?
Okay. So if you haven't seen season 1, you're two, because season 2 mostly takes place in another world.
Yeah, that's the part that confused the shit out of me.
I don't want to give too many spoilers away for when you watch it, though. Because, like, the show is just, it's so great.
It's about,
like,
magicians, though, right?
Smallest thing could easily spoil it. It's modern day, yes. Okay. It's very modern day. But it's like, it's not really about just magicians. It's kind of like Chronicles of Narnia meets modern day shit.
Okay, that's a better way to...
Yeah. Because, like, this other world is kind of like Narnia in a way.
Mm-hmm.
Only it's a lot more dangerous.
I was gonna say, the stuff in the promo for season 2 looked really cool.
Yeah, I especially love the white lady. She's funny. She's that white fey-looking creature.
I know what she looks like because I saw a behind-the-scenes thing.
She's funny. She's very arrogant and like, fuck you. I'm gonna do what I want.
Should we shift to a show that we both know?
And all love right. Oh gosh.
And die over. And over and over and over and over.
Now I'm scared.
Do you know what show I'm referring to?
I do know what show you're referring to. I just figured it out. Oh my god.
Who doesn't love?
Viewers, listeners, whatever you're called, fans, viewers. Get ready for
Hold on, real quick. Are they viewers or are they listeners? Guys, what do you want to be called? Do you want to be viewers or listeners? Let us know in the comments.
Until we come up with a cute name for our fans.
I'll never have one.
We can work on it.
Viewers or listeners, because it's on YouTube, but they're not exactly looking at anything.
Yeah.
Except for the picture of the butt.
They could be like buttlings. We're the butts, and they're the tiny butts. Buttlings.
Tyler, you took that too far. But yeah, if you can't tell... A show where they die over and over and over and over and over. It's obviously Supernatural.
Obviously.
Obviously that show ruined my life. Just kidding. It didn't. It did the very opposite, probably, for me. I'm one of those lame people. I'm like, Supernatural helped me. Which sounds awful, but, like, when you meet someone like that, like... Say you're on Tumblr and you're like, they're like, oh my gosh, Supernatural saved my life. Like, okay. Everybody has a story. Understand. But don't shove it in my face. That's what I feel like they do sometimes.
It's quite reminiscent of the whole big cock theory. It's all right to have one, but don't shove it in my face.
Mm-hmm.
That's like religion.
Yeah, I'll just say Supernatural was there for me through some tougher times. That's all.
It was, and it's full of so many feels and like just very, very stressing times.
Yep. I'd like to say I think I watched it during better times, but I really didn't. Like,
which is really strange because Supernatural is very dark.
Yeah. It is. I think I just like looked at the show because like I got started in high school with it. So like
I don't know, you.
Like 8 or 9 years ago, whatever. Probably almost 10 years ago I got started on it and I was like, well, at least it's not that bad.
I remember you were gonna try and make me and Tori play a D20 game of Supernatural with you.
I still have that. It's a very rare commodity.
Oh my god.
It is a Dungeons and Dragons style Supernatural game. And we actually did try to play it, and we ended up just throwing dice at each other and just going, Sammy! Really, like, all, the whole time. That's all we did.
We just screamed jerk and bitch at each other.
And it was who could make the deepest voice and try and sound like Dean and say Sammy.
I think there was also a time when somebody was pushed into a closet. I think it was Tori.
What? I don't remember that.
I don't know. I remember you were supposed to be Dean, she was Sam, and I was...
You were probably John, or Bobby.
No, because...
Because those are the only profiles that are in the book. I don't have the expansion for it.
I remember you guys always referring to me as... Because we gave each other roles.
Mm-hmm.
I always remember you guys referring to me as...
I could have sworn we called you Dad.
Ruby.
Oh, Ruby, are you sure? Wait. Well, I can see it. Okay. I was going to say, Rufus? Like, maybe Rufus?
Y'all were always just like, oh, Tyler's Ruby. And I'm like, I didn't understand what that meant at the time.
And now you get it.
I do.
We weren't trying
to... I don't like you so much.
We weren't trying to be mean. We just needed to give you a role, and that's just the one that we wanted to dub you. I should legit sit down and try and understand how to play that game after all these years. I don't think I have all my dice anymore, though. I'd have to go buy new dice.
I think they're the Golden Eagle comics over here.
Oh, but to stay on topic, because... We're already getting off topic.
Who stays on topic?
Yeah, let's see. Supernatural. I remember when it first aired. I distinctly remember the pilot episode. I just, like, kind of like, whatever. Like, I remember watching an early episode, season one, when I was young with my mom. Going, what's this? Who's that? What's this? And I think my mom was watching it. She was like, oh, this guy is in a soap opera I watched. Because Jensen Ackles was in Days of Our Lives at one point. So that's where she was like, oh, yeah, he's adorable, whatever.
Oh, my God. Dark Angel, though.
Yeah. I showed you Dark Angel.
You did, and I loved every single second.
Did you ever finish it?
Yes, I did.
Oh. That's good, because that's a good show. I tried to get... I literally almost just said Dean. I tried to get Will to watch that. And he was like, what is it? I don't want to start in the middle of it.
It is long done.
I'm like, no, it's not in the middle. It's just the good season. I'm saving you all the trouble. That was a good show. I really wish it would have made it longer than it did. But... Unfortunately, I think part of it was the ratings, and the other part was Jessica Alba wanted to do other things.
For real.
They had some good storylines lined up.
More half-naked Jensen Ackles.
Tyler, I think you're fixating on one thing.
No, no.
From both shows.
I mean, I can multitask.
we should discuss Demon Dean. That was my favorite thing, and I didn't even see those episodes. I just saw the clips and the gifs and the.
That was crazy.
I liked his hair in those episodes. It wasn't like ridiculously short. It had like length to it. I'm weird. Don't mind me.
Oh my god, it was really, really good. Like, just seeing Dean go all demon and just like the deep voice and like the it was wonderful. And he murdered people and
I know that. And he sang karaoke.
He destroyed the baby.
He sang karaoke.
He did, and it was oof.
Didn't he sing I'm Too Sexy?
He did. Did.
Did. I can't even. I'm dying. It's so funny to think about.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Did you ever?
The one episode, remember, where they were induced with fear?
Yes! The cat! Yes. The cat. The cat was the best. And the bloopers from that were great.
They really were.
That is the only season I still own of Supernatural, season 4. I took all of the rest and sold them when I needed money back in the day.
Sadness.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure you could buy them at FYE.
Yeah. I don't miss them. They're on Netflix. True. I have the one season that was, like, super important to me and that I love so much. I have it. I have season 4. That's fine. This is where I got to meet my favorite character, so. I'm good.
Oh my god, Cass.
I wish I could drop my voice and try and sound like him, but if I do it, I will probably literally hurt my vocal cords.
Speaking of Cass, guess what I did this year with a group of my friends?
You cosplayed as them.
No.
You did the Macarena.
I think we did at one point.
You gripped a man tight and raised him from perdition.
No, no, I can't do that.
You can't? Really? Yeah. I thought everybody could do that.
No, it's just damn. You.
Just me. Fuck.
No, actually, I competed with a group of 15 other people in Gishwish this year, which is a scavenger hunt run by Misha Collins, who plays Castiel. It was super fun. We were super out of our league. So we're gonna try again this year, and we're gonna see how it goes.
When is that?
It's in the summer.
Okay, when it happens this year, and you do it, if your group is not full, I don't know how many people you can have in a group anymore, because it's changed since the first year.
It has to be 15.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say, I know it's changed since he started it, because I remember the first year he did it. I want to participate so bad.
Oh my god, it was wonderful. We even made we made t-shirts and everything.
What were some of the stuff that you had to do?
Okay.
You're laughing already, because I can remember the very first year some of the objectives, because I had friends that were doing it, and I was like, I don't understand where this man is getting all these crazy ideas from.
So I was at the beach for the first, like, 2 or 3 days of Gishwish, and there were 2 beach objectives to do. One of them was to get a couch and actually throw it into the ocean and go couch surfing.
Dude, yes!
I could not find a couch.
Oh, you should have made one out of something.
The second one was to build a sand house, a sand castle. But it wasn't like a regular sandcastle. It is sand trailer park.
That's awesome. That's so cool.
What other ones did I do with them? We decorated a bus stop full of sticky notes with positive things written all over them.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, you had to work with like three other groups. So we all met up in Pottstown and we did it. What else did we do? Oh, we had to dress up in all of white clothing, like tennis clothing, and we had to go inside a mall and play badminton without like interacting with anybody and pretending that we don't know anybody is there.
Please, please, please tell me there's pictures or footage of that somewhere that I can see.
There is, in fact, footage.
Oh, thank God. I want to see this.
There is also footage of us in those very same whites drinking wine.
Oh, no.
Somebody is pouring wine out of a second story window in slow motion with Ave Maria playing in the background.
Okay, those are probably better than the ones that I remember from the first year.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm assuming it was the first year. I have a distinct memory of someone telling me they had to make a chandelier out of kale.
Oh my God, that was the kale year. Oh,
and be
God.
Functioning. And I went, there's no way in hell people are going to do that. And then were doing it.
They do.
And it was so cool. And was that the same year, or was that a different year when they did the clothing out of meat, like the Bacon Babes calendar?
That was the year before, I think.
Okay, I remember that. That was good. There was one where I saw people made a Skittles portrait of Jensen's face. That was really, really genius.
He actually made it a rule this year that people are not allowed to incorporate kale into anything.
Oh my gosh. Well, of course, because kale abuse.
Oh my God.
I remember Gwish's made the news, too, one of the years.
Mm-hmm.
Because people were launching things in the air. It was like, I don't know what they were trying. I think they were trying to send a tree. They like had a tree and they tied a bunch of balloons to it and they like tried to send it in the air. And it made, like, the local news of where it was happening.
Oh.
And then it started to get out that it was this competition. And then he was, like, promoting it, I remember. He was like, yeah, we're in the news. And I'm just like, you are a crazy, crazy son of a bitch. And I like it. He's my weird role model. Like, he tells me it's okay to be a freaking weirdo.
I love him. Oh, my God.
And fun fact, I share a birthday with his son.
Nice.
His firstborn. I was so excited. I cried on my birthday because I was like, he had a baby on my birthday. It was a big deal for me.
I saw him doing the ice. Remember when the ice bucket challenge was like a huge thing?
Mm-hmm.
He did one in his fucking bathtub.
That doesn't surprise me.
Like, he just laid in his bathtub.
I think I remember that.
Just to outdo Jensen and who else was doing Jensen?
Probably
Jensen.
Jared.
I don't know if Jared did it or not. The guy who plays Satan did it.
Crowley? Yeah. Lucifer.
No. Lucifer.
Okay. Mark Pellegrino.
Crowley's actor did too. Yeah.
I could talk for hours about the cast of Supernatural. They're all so wonderful.
I love them.
They're like, and if you meet them, they're so nice.
The day that I meet Jensen Ackles will be the day of my death.
I figured that one was coming. Like, I'll never forget. Like, okay, it's off topic, but it's still about a show. So when I did my first year of any convention, and I got to meet Mark Sheppard, I was in my costume as Castiel, and I was trying so hard to like try and slip into the Castiel character and keep a straight face and not to freak out and fangirl because I was standing right in front of him, and I had his full attention because there was nobody waiting behind me or around me to get his autograph or like to talk to him. So I was like, you need to give Bobby his soul back. Because it was like that. That's how long ago it was. And he just looked at me. And he said one of the lines from the show that he ended up saying in an episode. And I was just like, okay, thank you, bye! I panicked, and then my aunt was like, she's excited, I'm sorry. I'll never forget that, though. And there, he was so nice, he knew I was fucking scared of shit. And there's people that don't like his character. That upsets me. Crowley's cool.
I love Crowley so much.
You know who I do want to... Okay, so out of all the cast, since they're all so nice and they're very fan-friendly and, like, they're all about the fans, I would love to go meet Rob Benedict and Richard Spike Jr. They seem like they are just the goofiest, coolest dudes. And they're always, like, running things for the Creation Entertainment conventions.
Wait, Rob Benedict is Gabriel? Oh, wait, no.
No, you got it backwards. Richard Spike Jr. is yes. Gabriel, and then Rob yeah. Benedict is Chuck.
Chuck.
Plus, I like Chuck. I was like, I can relate to him.
Oh my god.
I was like, Gabriel. That's me. If I was a character, that'd be me. Scared shitless. You know you wouldn't make it in that universe.
No one would.
There we go. There's a good idea.
What?
Tyler, if you could be in any TV show and survive and have a decent way of living, what show would it be?
If I could survive and have a decent way of living. Depending on the show, do I get superpowers or not?
I mean, even non-superpowered people are pretty freaking handy.
I would have to say either the Magicians or Gotham.
Ooh, Gotham would be a good one. Although I haven't watched that show. I know somebody who knows somebody that was on that show as a detective, but haven't watched it. It's always, I know somebody who knows somebody. I never get to know the somebody. It never works out that way.
When does it ever?
Never.
Never, ever.
Is it weird if I want to say Bob's Burgers?
Oh my god.
Because that is, like, my all-time favorite TV show. I mean, watch it thousands of times, never get bored, never not laugh.
I mean, you basically already are freaking one of the characters.
Yeah. I could do it. I would still love 1 year to do Halloween with my sisters and all three of us dress up as Belcher kids. And then have my parents dress up as Bob and Linda.
Yes.
That'd be so fitting. And we already have it figured out. I would be Louise. Kelsey would be Tina. And Elizabeth would be Jean. She's the gross one. I'm the ringleader.
She's the gross one.
It's true. She's kind of weird and like that, and then Kelsey's she kind of fangirls now because she's getting older and she likes boys now, so
oh no,
yeah, it's a scary world for her and for boys and for me and my parents.
Oh my,
I think I'd survive pretty well. Let's see, what other shows? I watch a lot of The Office right now.
Which, oh my god.
That's just because I have to be doing something, and that's just a good filler for me.
Parks and Rec. Parks and Rec is, like, the all-time show for me. For, like, to go to something where I just really need to fucking die laughing.
Johnny Karate. I quite like that part of the show. And when they had the snake hole... Or the snake juice.
Oh, God.
She's like, it is straight rat poison. They're all drunk. And Ben just goes, Baba Booey.
Baba Booey.
Oh, and Ben and his love for calzones.
Yes.
They betrayed me?
Oh my god. Freaking Andy. Andy is bae.
Oh, I loved Andy.
When he's drunk. Farts and poop and love and stuff. Macaroni salad.
And Bert Macklin.
Oh my god.
The show is just a classic.
It really
is. I'm sure a lot of people would be like, that's not a classic. Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. Another good classic? Friends.
I've been rewatching Friends.
Friends.
Friends, like... Okay, so usually if I feel like I need to look at my life and my choices and judge myself, I'll watch Gilmore Girls. But lately it's been Friends. Which is really weird, but it, like, makes me self-reflect a little bit. Because I'm like, because we're at the same age as those characters were. And I'm just like, oh, wow. I'm like, I'm a Monica.
So what am I? Don't you dare say Phoebe.
Tyler.
Don't you dare say Phoebe.
But Rachel and I already figured out who everyone is.
Oh, okay, good. Who am I?
She's Rachel. Brad is... Actually, no. I'm pretty sure we couldn't decide who I would be. So they're like, yeah, you're just a combination of Chandler and Monica. And I think we said Will was Joey. Which is really mean. And I think by default that would make you
Phoebe. Of course. Of course. I have to be Phoebe now.
Why not? Phoebe was a good character.
My name is not Phoebe.
She just runs weird.
In a hammock.
She just runs weird.
My name is Princess Consuela Banana Hammock.
Hey, she did lots of good stuff, man. She had smelly cats. She found a thumb in a can of soda and got $7,000 and then gave it to And then she gave it to Chandler to quit smoking. That's the episode I just watched the other night. It's a good show. It's a good show. I'm trying to think of like something else that's like old. Arrested Development.
Wait, what?
Arrested Development?
Oh yeah.
That's a good show. I can't like plow through it, though. I have to, like, watch that in increments if I want to rewatch it.
Uh-huh.
I really want them to put out a new season for it, too. Because they've been discussing it with Netflix again. To get that sixth season. What else? What other... I can't think of other shows that I like.
Oh. If we're going on the Netflix area, Sense8 is a very, very good show.
I haven't watched that.
It's really good.
Like, really? I read what it's about, and it seemed confusing to me.
How so?
Because they're all attached? Yes. Like, mentally?
Psychically.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So how does that work?
Okay, so... excuse me. So the basic premise of it is that there is a group of eight, and I forget what they're called. There's like a certain name for them. I haven't watched it in like over. But they're all psychically connected. They aren't at first. They have to be awoken first. And that's how the beginning starts. Is that this lady, like, she's about to die, and she was part of the previous eight that are being hunted down by this guy, where all he has to do is like look in your eyes and he can see like everybody that's inside your eight. Like, he knows where they are, what they're seeing, like everything. And as she's about to die, she wakes them up, and they actually watch her die. Like, it's like a dream to them, but they're all there. They all see her die. And then they wake up the next morning and they're like, that's fucking weird. And then throughout their day, they'll just see people that aren't supposed to be there. Like, they'll see somebody that lives in China, like, just all of a sudden appear right next to them. Fuck. And then they'll, this other person will, like, hear them and they'll understand them, even though they speak different languages, because their brains are all connected to each other. So they can feel, like, what each other feels. They can think what each other thinks. Like, they can jump into each other's bodies and, like, help them.
That's cool.
And it's, like, really cool.
Yeah, I know that show, like a lot of people were like, oh my God, so good, but I
It's really, really.
just never watched it.
Warning, there is an orgy scene in
Oh.
it.
Does it involve eight people? Are you counting right now?
Five, six, seven. Yes, exactly eight.
Is
But
it?
it's not those eight. Their lovers actually jump into it.
Oh, that's nice.
I don't know how that works, but it works. Like, I think there's like two couples that are part of it. And it's very, very proactive for like modern day stuff. Like it's proactive for like gays and transgenders and
LGBTQ plus.
yeah. 'Cause I know one of the characters is she had the surgery. She went from male to female, and her mother hates it now and is trying to like ruin life.
Oh,
But
that's.
she's in like a lesbian relationship with another girl, and the other girl like knows about her changing. It's very interesting.
I have to look into it. Like, it's. I'll just put it on my list because, I'm supposed to start watching Stranger Things.
I'm supposed to start watching Stranger Things as well.
Yeah, everybody's on my ass about it, and now I actually have like legitimate people that I'm friends with going, you need to watch this.
I
I
also
just
need
sat
to
and
fin
watched the whole thing.
I also need to finish what's that new show that everybody's talking about? I only watched like three or four episodes of it. Shameless.
Shameless isn't new.
No. But I have only watched like three or four episodes of it.
I've seen season one. Season one was good. And I like started rewatching it with Will, and he was like, "This isn't bad." I was like, "No, it's not bad. It's pretty good. It's just kind of there's so many storylines to follow."
Yeah.
See, the problem with a lot of shows, I find like for me, I'll watch four like four three or four episodes. It's usually four. And then that's where I go, okay, I'm gonna keep watching, or I just lose my interest and I stop watching. Which
That's
was supposed to be the original podcast that I was supposed to do with someone else actually like months ago, but it just never happened. We were gonna like do a four episode review of shows and like should you keep watching it or should you stop watching it, and just never happened. It's still a good idea. Somebody
is.
can make it happen, but not it's not gonna be me. Y'all can take credit for it. I don't need to do it. But yeah, Arrow, I can't get past the fourth or fifth episode. Once upon a time, I struggled getting past the fourth or fifth episode.
I got pretty far in Once Upon a Time when as it was coming out. But yeah, I was watching it like as it came out, and then like we had caught up to it with using Netflix. And then I lost my Netflix account because it was like mooching off of my friend's Netflix account at the time. And then I moved. I couldn't really watch it for a while after that. It was like a year. Came back and I was like, oh, Once Upon a Time, yay! And then I was like, I can't watch this anymore. I'm like already three seasons in and I don't remember anything, so I have to start at the beginning. I'm not gonna do this right now.
That's literally what I did. I think I watched it. I got like four episodes in, let it sit for a good year or 2 years, went back, went, you know, I should probably try and give this a try again. So I did, and I think I stopped. It was before Jefferson, because that was the only reason I was watching the show. I heard about the Mad Hatter and Jefferson and who was playing him, and I went, yes, please. And I think I stopped right before his episode, which was, I think, episode 18. Yeah, that's about right. I think I got to, like, maybe 12, 13. I don't know. It's crazy.
It is.
It's very crazy. And it's not a classic. And it's not, like, a nostalgic thing for me, but Vampire Diaries is ending this year.
Oh, God, Vampire Diaries.
Season 8. It's final season, man.
Oh.
I'm going to look at my autographed picture of Damon. Damon. I'm going to look at that and go, we had a good run. We had a good run when we watched one season of it.
Ian Somerhalder. Oh.
You know, I used to think he was cute. I did. I was like, you know, he's not bad looking. He has really pretty eyes, if anything.
He is beautiful.
And then I saw him do a live stream on Facebook, and I was like, wow, you're looking old.
Wow.
Maybe it's just, like, awful to say, but I was like, oh my gosh, you're not young anymore. I think, I told someone, and they got really mad about it, because they're like, I hate your opinion, but I like the originals more than Vampire Diaries.
The original, yeah.
Their storylines are so much better.
True Blood. I loved True Blood.
I tried True Blood.
I loved True Blood.
And when I say I tried True Blood, I mean I physically drank True Blood. I used to buy that stuff because it was like crack to me. And then they stopped making it because the show ended.
Yep.
And I still have a bottle of it. I think I have two bottles, empty bottles, actually. And it makes me laugh every time I look at it because it was essentially like a highly, highly caffeinated energy drink. And there was a warning label on the back that was like, if you are pregnant or you have problems consuming caffeine, please don't drink this. I was like, oh, God. It was so good. I watched, I think, one season of the show. I think I did. I got through season one. I saw a little bit of two because I remember Jessica. She was really cute. I liked her. Do you watch the new one that everybody was raving about, like, I want to say 3 months ago?
Uh-huh.
Westworld?
No, I have not.
I heard good things about that. I haven't watched it. I was hoping you might have.
Nope.
What else is there? How about Teen Wolf?
Oh, Teen Wolf.
I love my wolves.
I do, too.
I love my wolves.
Teen Wolf. That show just does things to you. It's just... It gives your body the tingles.
It doesn't. I really love the characters. Well, let me rephrase that. I really love the characters in the first two seasons. Mm-hmm. And maybe part of season three. And then from there, I was like, I don't like these kids now. There's new ones and... And I don't like keeping up with names and faces, so we're done. Teen Wolf's like Supernatural. It'll always have a special little place in my heart.
So I feel like we should address the elephant show in the room. The Walking Dead.
Oh no, Tyler, we can't talk about The Walking Dead.
So
we can't talk about it.
I can't. I haven't watched it in so, like, it just, I stopped watching before Glenn died, apparently. Like, I was just like done because I'm just like, I'm gonna hate this now.
Do you mean when he was under like the dumpster and everybody thought he was dead?
I was before that too.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you probably got a little farther than me. I stopped watching. First off, I couldn't even watch the show when it came out. Like, I was excited, I wanted to watch it, and that's kind of when I was still seeing a therapist about zombies and my beliefs on that, and they kind of advised me to stay away from it. So when I finally did watch it, like I got through the first season, it was good. I locked myself in a room after watching it, but it was good. Yeah, I watched I think I want to say I got through season two and part of three. The last thing I remember Lori dying. That did a number on me. I couldn't handle that.
Yes.
And I did not get to see the governor storm the prison in his big tank. So that's as far as I got. I never saw that. I never saw Herschel's death. I remember seeing Merle die. Because I threw a party when he died. I threw like a miniature party with myself. I was like, yeah, he's dead.
I
I
still
don't
kind
like this
of felt
actor.
bad. I still kind of felt bad though,
I felt
because
bad too, because I did like the character. Like he sure he was a dick, but
I love Daryl, and Daryl was sad.
that too.
I was sad because Daryl
I think my whole thing the fact that I stopped watching the show was I saw so many of the cast members at Wizard World, and it just became like I was watching it and I'm like, oh, that's not believable anymore. You know? I was like, the magic's gone. Like I shook Norman Reedus's hand. The magic is gone.
Magic is going.
The magic's in my hand. Insert lewd
Watching
joke here.
it again.
Oh, by the way, fun fact for anybody listening, tuning in, viewing, whatever we're gonna say.
Butlings.
But little my little buttlings, Mr. Michael Rooker is Merle in real life.
Yes.
And I'm very disappointed in how my interaction with him at that convention went. I won't go into it because then it's going to turn into a 20-minute rant.
Don't even think we have 20 minutes left.
No, we don't have 20 minutes left in the podcast. Let's see. Let's think of another. What's a good show we could go with?
Silently passes Naruto across the
No anime. No more anime. We did our anime spew. We gotta.
Anime is life. Ooh, Vikings. Vikings was really good.
Haven't watched it.
I'm still really into it.
Want to watch it though.
It's really good. It's getting more dramatic, like it's losing more of its like actual Viking sort of side, and it's turning more into Game of Thrones.
We don't have to talk about Game of Thrones because I've never watched Game of Thrones.
I have watched up to past season 3, and then I haven't watched anymore.
Nope, didn't watch it. I refused to watch it till I read the book, and I've been sitting on that book for like 5 years now.
In books.
Oh no, I only have the first one.
Oh God. Oh.
I know there's a bunch.
Don't get attached to anyone.
Oh, I know. I heard about the Red Wedding.
There's like so many different freaking things about weddings. It's just like you don't need to like ever go to a wedding in Game of Thrones. People are gonna die.
I like the Bob's Burgers Game of Thrones thing they did with the cats and Aunt Gail.
Yes.
Louise's sword out of hand and she just smacked people. Oh,
I also enjoy South Park's rendition.
Yes, I forgot they did theirs with Princess Kenny.
Yes, Princess Zucchini.
It's Princess Kenny, guys.
They were fighting over whether they should get a PS4 or Xbox One.
That's what it was about?
Yes.
I never saw it.
That is what it was about.
Like,
was
I know it was Black Friday, right?
Black Friday, yep.
I know, like, it's Black Friday, and I know they all dressed up and stuff, but I didn't know what they were battling about.
Because Cartman wanted a Xbox One, Cartman and Kenny, and then Stan and Kyle wanted the PS4.
It all makes sense now.
And they all started freaking turning on each other. Cartman would take people into this old guy's freaking garden, and he would yell at them every time he took somebody in.
Oh my gosh. See, South Park is a show that's, I'll honestly say that's a guilty pleasure show. Like, I know it's awful.
I love it.
It's crude, and I know I shouldn't like it, but
I love it. I cannot wait. I cannot wait for the new game. I'm so excited.
It's never coming out.
Keep pushing it.
It's never coming out, Tyler. It's going to turn into The Last Guardian. We're going to wait 5 years.
It's going to turn into freaking Kingdom Hearts 3.
Oh, God, that's even worse. That game's not even out.
No.
I think I was... I don't have Hulu anymore, so I can't watch South Park, because they're the only service that has it all seasons. I think I was at, like, season 13 or 14.
Or you could just go to ComedyCentral.com and watch them all.
So I guess maybe to close it, since we've got a good like 10 minutes left, we should like name off some shows we want to watch or that we're excited for.
Ooh, mine are majorly anime.
Tyler, you gotta be excited for real people and real shows too.
Not always so much because I hate people.
Like, I'm excited to watch... Oh, God, now I gotta think of something. I didn't have an answer thought up. I thought you would have one off the top of your head. Oh, I know! You're just
gonna bandwagon on mine.
This is the stupidest... I'm sure it's the dumbest show, but I love... Oh, my God, I can't think of his name. The guy who gets high, Doug something. You know who I mean?
Yeah. You're talking about Breaking Bad, I think.
No.
No? Okay.
That show's done. I know Breaking Bad's over. I've never finished that either. I'm looking up his name really quick.
I am personally really excited for more...
Doug Benson! Doug Benson. What?
Okay.
What, he has a show on Comedy Central called The High Court, where he gets high and he oversees a small court procedure.
Oh, God.
And I saw a clip and was crying. That's how funny it was. But go ahead. That's the I'm excited for that show. I'll think of another one while you...
I am really excited for more Steven Universe, personally.
Oh, yeah.
Steven Universe is such a great show. And more RWBY. Although that's more of a web show. But it's still a show.
I count it as a show. It's on Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited to see... I'm not caught up at all. Mm-hmm. I'm excited to see the end of Adventure Time.
Oh, I never got to see the end of Adventure Time either.
Well, it's not... They're doing the final... They just finished recording the final season.
I haven't seen, like, any of it, though. Like,
I've seen a lot of it on DVD, but I don't think the DVDs are, like, in an order.
They're not. It angers my soul.
But I'm excited to see how they end it all. Because that show had a really good run. I even tweeted their last day, like, the guy who voices Jake the Dog.
Uh-huh.
He tweeted last day, and he put a picture of the cake that they made. It was like, goodbye, Adventure Time. And I tweeted, I'm like, you guys did such a great job on this show. Thank you for everything. Like, because essentially my sisters grew up with that show at this point. Uh-huh. And I was like, you guys are so good, thank you. And he liked my tweet, and I cried. Uh-huh. I ran screaming, I'm like, he liked my tweet! but no, I kind of can't wait to see how that ends. It's not often you get to see a show end that went on for like 8 seasons.
That's true. It makes you cry.
It's upsetting.
Heroes. hero is made distraught.
You know what? I'm looking up upcoming TV shows really quick. Don't mind.
And I watched Heroes Reborn, and I liked it at first, but after, like, the eighth episode, I was just kind of like, this is not that great anymore.
No, Heroes Reborn was something else. It wasn't, it didn't feel like Heroes.
But then in Heroes Reborn, they're like, oh, all the original heroes are dead. And I'm like, oh, just fucking rip my heart out.
How about, stuff by Ryan Murphy?
I haven't seen that show yet.
No, just, he's got like 5 shows, Tyler.
Which one?
American Horror Story, American Crime Story, and Feud.
I was in love with American Horror Story, and then he ruined it.
I'm a little curious as to what he's going to do with the upcoming season. They said recently in an interview that it's going to be politics related in regards to this past year.
Mm-hmm.
Which, screw that.
Scary enough.
Yeah, screw that. Give me my crossover season that I want. Like,
yes. Or do the Dollhouse that everybody's been talking about. Oh my god, I would be terrified of that.
A what?
There was a rumor going around that a new season was going to be about a dollhouse. Like, a museum full of dolls and shit.
That'd be interesting.
I was just like, I would not be able to handle that.
You say dollhouse, and I'm thinking of the young adult book, The Doll People.
Ugh.
No, it was cute. It was a cute book about a doll and how a new doll came, and it was like the dolls adapting, and it was like the doll family, and they weren't all the same, but they were a family. It was a cute book. Like, I'm thinking of that.
I hate dolls so much. Ugh, they're so creepy.
Let's see, what other shows? There's, Twin Peaks is coming back. It's, I don't know if it's, like, a full revival or if it's, like, a continuation. Also, American Gods, which is from Neil Gaiman, so I'm sure that'll be great.
You know what show I really miss, to Star be Trek. Honest? Yes.
I don't know, there's a new Star Trek show coming out, too.
There's a new one?
Yeah, Star Trek Discovery.
Screams.
It looks pretty cool, but they're changing the Klingons! I don't know how I feel about that.
No. Actually, I was going to say Gravity Falls.
Oh, is that still going on?
No, it's over.
Oh.
Sadly.
I thought you were going to tell me there's another season. I was like, wait, what?
I kind of wish. Like, I am happy where they left off, but at the same time, I'm kind of sad because it's over. Just like I was really sad when Ed, Edd n Eddy ended.
Oh my god. I feel like that show never truly ended, though.
It did.
They just kind of dropped it and were like, that's it, no more. Because the story didn't have it. There was no story.
Well, they made a movie about their like last episode, quote unquote, was about them finding Eddie's brother.
Oh, I didn't see that ever. That could be why.
But that's, like, their ending, and it was a happy ending, but, like, at the same time, it just left a lot to be, like, wanted.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you wanted to know more about, like, what happens after that.
Like, how they grew up, and...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we could do a whole episode of the podcast on, like, old, like, kid shows.
Our childhood, you mean?
Specifically the shows, because... All I ever did was watch TV as a kid.
Yeah.
Which was so bad, but I don't care. I read a lot of books, too. Y'all can judge me all you want.
I was, obsessed with the Harry Potter books as a child.
I wasn't. I had them, I read them, but I wasn't.
But, those were, like, the only type of books that I really read. And then TV was my life.
Nope. I was pretty well balanced. I did a lot of reading, and I did a lot of watching. Then again, like, all I ever watched was Dragon Ball Z. And whatever was on Toonami is what we watched. The good old days when we could, like, sit down at, like, 5 o'clock and just watch the Toonami lineup. Now, if you want to watch Toonami, you gotta stay up to what? Like, midnight? I think it starts at, like, 11:30, 12 o'clock?
I don't know. I actually didn't even know Toonami was back, to be honest.
Yeah, they kind of sneak it into Adult Swim now. Like they used to do. Although, when they used to sneak it in with Adult Swim, it was like one night a week. They wouldn't call it Toonami.
It was like Saturdays.
Yeah, it was like on a Saturday at like 2 in the morning, they'd have like a 4-hour block of anime, and then that would be it for like all week. That's your anime fix for the week. Just like how our podcast is your fix of great, strange, and weird conversation for your week. Which is a good segue into closing thoughts, Tyler.
Mm-hmm.
Closing thoughts.
Thoughts.
God damn it. Every time.
My closing thoughts. There are always a lot of new ideas popping up every day, and I love the different ideas that people can come up with. Some of them aren't so great, but you just get those ones that you're just, like, obsessed with, and it's just, like, I need more. And it becomes, like, an addiction. And it's just, that's where I'm at with the magicians right now. I need more. But when you finally find that, like, one show that's where you can't stop watching, that's just, like, perfection at its finest.
Which is why you don't watch Lost, kids.
Oh.
I mean, nope. You should watch Lost, but you're never going to do anything for a, like, 4-week span except for watch Lost and talk about Lost and recite the numbers. And I guess my closing thoughts will be Riverdale. Fuck that show. That's my whole closing thought. Riverdale, fuck that show. I don't know. It's got me hooked, and it's kind of destroying my comical childhood. Mm-hmm. But I don't know. It's weird. It feels like Teen Wolf a little bit, so I'm kind of stuck on it. I'm probably gonna finish watching it tonight at some point.
At some point.
Probably.
Probably after that.
Maybe after this. I have some other stuff to record still, so I don't know. But, as usual, you know where to find us. Everything's down in the description. Tyler's on Twitter. I'm on Twitter. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. We're trying to hit that 100 subscriber count at the speed of turtle, which is fine. I don't care.
The speed of turtle.
I love it. I don't care. I like it too much to care at this point. And don't forget to appreciate that butt of the week of Miss Scarlett Johansson. Mm-hmm. And we'll catch you next time.
Bye.